this is Hooked by Happenstance. I'm Kendra, and it is time for chapter 36 of Yarn Tales. It's loud in my house right now, so we're out here, and it was windy on the porch, so just inhale and enjoy the beautiful lilac smell that I am enjoying in my sunbeam, wherever you are right now. So today we're going to add another chapter to my reading shawl. My reading shawl and yarn tales is an ongoing series here at Hooked by Happenstance where I read books, I tell you a bit about them, and then I apply silly Kendra rules to my star rating, and I add a segment to my reading shawl. Now my reading shawl began as what I thought was just going to be a year-long project to add 12 to 15 stripes to one shawl. I'm on shawl number 3 for the year, and we are on book 37. And we are on book 36. So, obviously, the shawl is doing its job, and I am reading more because of it. I'm finding it particularly useful to read books and have a tangible outcome in the form of the shawl, and it helps me kind of feel encouraged to keep going because I see all of the other things that I've read so far this year. It's like a nice way to look back. So right now we're talking about books that I read during Fantasy-a-thon, which was a week-long read-a-thon in March, to encourage you to read more fantasy books. There were a few challenges, and I will tell you what challenges that this book pertained to. But the book in question today is How to Train Your Dragon by Cressida Cowell. I read it aloud to my family. So we got this book from our local library, and I started reading it in the car to everybody on the way home, my hub and stance included, so all 5 of us. And then we got home, and we were all like, so, what happens next? So I kept reading, and then we needed to go and deliver some birthday cookies to a friend who worked, I don't know, about 20, 25 minutes away. So I read in the car, and I read in the car on the way home, and then we all hunkered on the couch and I finished the book. So we read the entirety of this book in one day aloud as a family, and it was a really, really nice experience. So the experience gets like all the stars, right? The book itself was enjoyable. The characters were cute. The names are adorable. The plot, I actually thought, had some things I would not have like readily thought of, and I enjoyed that. I thought it was a good overarching story. There were definitely some areas that I thought could have been bumped up a little that would have made it 5 stars, but I overall gave How to Train Your Dragon 4 stars. And then I found out there were like 12 books in this series. I knew there was more than one. I didn't know there were so many. So obviously we have another series to add to our want to read list, and we will be getting to those as time goes on. So let me show you my shawl. So my shawl has 4 different yarns in it. One for books that I read with my kids. One for Books for My Life's library subscription, where I get a new book every 6 weeks. One for audiobooks that I experience by myself. And one for physical books that I experience by myself. Well, obviously, this fell into the books with the kid category. And the yarn in question definitely took it up a notch. If there was any question that this was my green shawl, that question is no longer, because I've added a very, very, very green stripe. The yarn for the books with my kids is a cattails yarn. It's on her DK base, and it's called The Green Man. And it is all the greens. This is from her Wheel of Time collection. And what I do with each of the yarns is there is a different pattern section that goes with it. So I do the pattern section and then a row of textured single crochet for each star that I rate the book. So we have pattern section and then 4 rows of textured single crochet. I also went ahead and threw some gold beads in. These are actually metal, and they're every other single crochet V has one, because this was for a readathon. So that's kind of how I'm demarcating that in my shawls, so I can see all the fun that we've had doing readathons and such. And I really, really like how adding this yarn in just completely changed the way the other yarns were reading. This was reading as a really golden brown shawl, and as soon as this yarn started getting added, it was like poof, all the color kind of popped. So I am really looking forward to continuing on. This is not the only book that I read during March with my kids. So, this is not the last book that's getting added to the shawl that I read with my kids. So there will be more of this color in here. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how these like really bright pops make things like the greens in this, the waist colorway, make it pop throughout. So I am super excited to see where the shawl is going. If you want to see the rest of the chapters of Yarn Tales so far, there is a playlist here on the channel. And subscribe if you don't want to miss out on the future chapters, because I do not post on a regulated schedule. So the best way to not miss out on things is just let them float into your subscription feed by hitting that subscribe button. And I will see you all next time. Bye! We are on book 36. So, obviously, the shawl is doing its job, and I am reading more because of it. I'm finding it particularly useful to read books and have a tangible outcome in the form of the shawl, and it helps me kind of feel encouraged to keep going because I see all of the other things that I've read so far this year. It's like a nice way to look back. So right now we're talking about books that I read during Fantasy-a-thon, which was a week-long read-a-thon in March. To encourage you to read more fantasy books, there were a few challenges, and I will tell you what challenges this book pertained to. But the book in question today is How to Train Your Dragon by Cressida Cowell. I read it aloud to my family. So we got this book from our local library, and I started reading it in the car to everybody on the way home, my hub and stance included, so all five of us. And then we got home, and we were all like, so what happens next? So I kept reading, and then we needed to go and deliver some birthday cookies to a friend who worked, I don't know, about 20, 25 minutes away. So I read in the car, and I read in the car on the way home, and then we all hunkered on the couch and I finished the book. So we read the entirety of this book in one day aloud as a family, and it was a really, really nice experience. So the experience gets like all the stars, right? The book itself was enjoyable. The characters were cute. The names are adorable. The plot, I actually thought, had some things I would not have like readily thought of, and I enjoyed that. I thought it was a good overarching story. There were definitely some areas that I thought could have been bumped up a little that would have made it 5 stars, but I overall gave How to Train Your Dragon 4 stars. And then I found out there were like 12 books in this series. I knew there was more than one. I didn't know there were so many. So obviously we have another series to add to our want to read list, and we will be getting to those as time goes on. So let me show you my shawl. So my shawl has 4 different yarns in it. 1 for books that I read with my kids. 1 for books for my life's library subscription, where I get a new book every 6 weeks. 1 for audiobooks that I experience by myself, and 1 for physical books that I experience by myself. Well, obviously this fell into the books with the kid category, and the yarn in question definitely took it up a notch. If there was any question that this was my green shawl, that question is no longer, because I've added a very, very, very green stripe. The yarn for the books with my kids is a cattails yarn. It's on her DK base, and it's called the Green Man, and it is all the greens. This is from her Wheel of Time collection, and what I do with each of the yarns is there is a different pattern section that that goes with it. So I do the pattern section and then a row of textured single crochet for each star that I rate the book. So we have pattern section and then 4 rows of textured single crochet. I also went ahead and threw some gold beads in. These are actually metal, and they're every other single crochet V has one, because this was for a readathon. So that's kind of how I'm demarcating that in my shawls, so I can see all the fun that we've had doing readathons and such. And I really, really like how adding this yarn in just completely changed the way the other yarns were reading. This was reading as a really golden brown shawl, and as soon as this yarn started getting added, it was like poof, all the color kind of popped. So I am really looking forward to continuing on. This is not the last book that's getting added to the shawl that I read with my kids, so there will be more of this color in here. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how these like really bright pops make things like the greens in this, the waist colorway, make it pop throughout. So I am super excited to see where the shawl is going. If you want to see the rest of the chapters of Yarn Tales so far, there is a playlist here on the channel. And subscribe if you don't want to miss out on the future chapters, because I do not post on a regulated schedule. Bye!